Our first attempt at a data call used the rather generic getValues method associated with our selected AF attribute object. As of the AF SDK 2.5, we have some more powerful and extended options for getting values. I'm going to go back to the AF SDK help file here and look at the What's New section. Now, we've got notes going all the way back in time, but really, what's new, as of AF SDK 2.5, is there's a data namespace. And in this AF data namespace, we now have extended AF data options for our attributes. Let's look at this. For any AF attribute, we can now ask for interpolated values, specifically, values to be interpolated at certain times, values suitable for plotting, recorded values, just as they are in the archive, and any sort of summaries that we want. If you're familiar with the PySDK, or if you've used anything like PyDataLink, a lot of this functionality looks familiar, and as of AF SDK 2.5, we now have it here at our disposal in AF. Let's look at adding this as options to our applet. We will give the users a combo box to select, specifically, what kind of data call that they want to make. Perhaps we'll offer three options initially. My combo box here can be called CB data method. And the three choices that we will give, if we go down to items in the collection, we can give three choices. Like, just the raw values out of the archive would be recorded values. If we want to give values interpolated on some time step, we can offer interpolated values. Or if we're interested in making a data call for values that can be plotted, we'll go with plot values. Plot values actually deserves a little bit of a shout out here. If we look at it in the help, it tells us that it retrieves values suitable for typically, a fixed number of pixels. Imagine we're making a trend for a user that shows the last year of production, or the last day's worth of flow through a pipe. Well, if our trend is only 200 pixels wide, we don't want to return 2 million values to plot in 200 pixels. We want to return just enough values that draw an accurate trend for those 200 pixels. Simple interpolation might not show really the full range of what goes on, so this plot values has a neat little algorithm behind it that will return just enough data values to visually represent the maximum and minimum and the entry point and exit point for each vertical slice in time. 200 pixels worth of trend, we will give you enough data to accurately reflect what that data looked like, but not return just everything from the archive. So anyway, we'll offer that as one of our options. Recorded values, interpolated values, and plot values. Now I'm going to copy these guys to the clipboard, because I'm about to make a big select statement that uses those as options. So I'll copy those to the clipboard and say OK. Alright, so within my data call, or within that button for getting data, we will now handle the different cases of which data call a user wants to make. So, we will respond to the cbData method text. And here I'm going to paste in everything from my clipboard. and just get it formatted up here as the different cases that we might want to be selecting or switching. Just get this hammered in here. Okay, so now for each of these possible scenarios, we can make an appropriate data call. So instead of making this one AFValues call down there, just to the generic getValues, I'll have an item to hold this these results. So let's see, if someone wants recorded values, we can take a look at our selected attribute and look at this afdata object. Now you'll notice that it's in the af.data namespace. So for the sake of sanity, we're going to add that as a using statement. Now let's see. Selected attribute.data. Sure enough, there's that recorded values method here. You might be wondering, wait a minute, didn't we already get the recorded values using that simpler get values call? Well, yeah, we did, but we've got some extra options now. In addition to specifying that time range, we can now specify a boundary type for the values. Earlier, we saw that when we asked for example, material of the tank, which is a constant, between 3 hours ago and now, it interpolated results for us at the boundaries. So the generic case of getValues just uses an interpolated method. But specifically, if we only want values inside our time range, or if we want the physical values just outside the time range, everything inside plus the physical value just on the other side, we can also specify that outside boundary type. For now, we'll just say interpolated is fine. Pass a desired unit of measure. Then we get to some things that we don't really recognize. So I will point out that we've got good help and can take a look at this filter expression and whether or not to include filtered values. If we wish to filter the values by some condition, we can specify that, for example, I only want to know the values of level when the safety valve is open, or I only want to know the values of level when the mass is above a certain thing. This might make a lot more sense in the summary calls. If we're asking for an average, we want to filter that average to only consider cases when the mass is above or below a certain value. Can be really useful then. If we don't want to filter, then we just pass a null. So here, let's just pass a null. Now this recorded values call returns our old friend the AFValues collection, which is good. Let's say, there we go. And now, I'm going to do similar things for the interpolated values and the plot values. Okay, so now we have the same thing except for, additionally, interpolated values and plot values. Now, interpolated values, of course, is going to take some time span, and every here, 5 minutes, within that time range, we will interpolate a value. Plot values, as mentioned before, allows us to say, hey, we're trying to plot, make a plot 300 pixels wide, give me just enough data to make an accurate visual representation of whatever time range. So let's see if this works. Let's try it out. To make my compiler happy, I am going to add a default case here, where we just assign an empty case to the values collection. Okay, let's see if my compiler is happy now. Ta-da, it is. So, look at one of my tanks, try and find its mass, get some, oh, the interpolated values. And there we go. Every 5 minutes, we have a value interpolated for mass. Looks great. That also works for constants like capacity. I can get values suitable for plot, say for the level, just enough values to make a 300 pixel wide plot, or whatever size I specify. So now, what happens if I go up and I want to know the mass of my tank farm? I innocently select the mass of the tank farm, everything seems to be working great, but I hit the Get Data button, and I get an exception. It tells me that the data method plot values is not supported on the attribute mass for the tank farm. Well, what's going on? You'll recall that when we configured this tank farm, we calculated the tank farm mass using a custom data reference, the rollup data reference. It's been available on vCampus since 2010. It's a few versions ago of the AF SDK. So the data reference still works great, but it doesn't have these new rich data functions that only became available in AF SDK 2.5. Now, it turns out, it's not entirely hard to add that functionality to this data reference. You can do that. The code is on vCampus. But the effect for us as users is that it's a good idea to check if a given data reference supports these new rich data methods that have become available as of AF SDK 2.5. So in our code, we will add a check for if the selected attribute dot supported data methods contains the flag for each of our options. So if we have that data reference supported, then we will make the data call. Otherwise, we'll probably just need to stick to a default collection. So we'll do this for each of our cases here. If the selected attribute has the flag for AF data methods dot interpolated values, then here we go, we can make that data call again. Okay, so I'm going to pause the video and do the same thing to plot values. There we go. Let's test this out and see how it works. We'll start by just one of the normal ones and see if that works. Okay, so we didn't break the normal case, but if I try and go up to Tank Farm and get its mass, then, sure enough, we don't make the data call, and we can let the user know, if we'd like, that that data reference probably needs to be updated to include the rich data functionality. So there you have it. We can offer these expanded data functions to the users and allow them to do things like interpolating values at certain times, applying filters to them, or, interestingly, applying summaries like averages, maximums, minimums, etc. One final thing to note is, similar to these expanded data methods, we can also do calculations on the fly, on demand, in AF. Again, if you're familiar with the Pi SDK or with Pi Data Link, this comes as no surprise to you. You can write an expression in the Pi performance equation syntax to, for example, find the maximum sum of three Pi tags. You know, not the independent maximum of each, but if you want to know when the sum of three Pi tags hits its maximum over a day, this would be a way to do it. So, I'll leave that to you to look more into that AF calculation interface and to PI performance equation syntax.